Hello, Bull Riding fans, and welcome to When the Dust Settles. I am Z-Man, your host, and like I said, this is When the Dust Settles. The PBR had its seventh stop on the Ford Built Tough Tour, and it was an arena event. Now, the arena event is a little different than your typical other events. You have just your regular event, which is, they break it down in between 3 and 2 days. And, your top 10 go to a short round, and then your final day, the top 10 go to the Ford Built Tough round, and that's how you decide a champion of the event. Well, the arena event is a little different. One, in an arena, they were in the Georgia Dome in Atlanta, Georgia, and what it is, it's a one-day event, and you ride your first bull. If you ride your first bull, you get a second bull. And then they figure out the two rides, and you know, whoever has the best average of the two rides ends up being victorious. Well, last week the PBR had its first arena event, and it was very good. Actually made guys take their re-rides, because on the arena event, where it's only one day, if your bull doesn't perform and you get that re-ride option, you have to take it, you know, because you want to be able to be seated well when you get into the short round. First off, I want to say a couple weeks ago in Baltimore, we haven't had a show since, you know, before Baltimore, the PBR said goodbye to to a couple bull riders, one being a fan favorite, you know, Ben left, you know. He didn't make the cut. You know, we didn't think he was going to. He started off really bad. The first few weeks, he wasn't riding his bulls. You know, unfortunately, Ben Jones didn't make the cut. You know, the PBR had to say so long to Ben Jones. Actually, not the PBR, the Ford Built Tough Series had to say goodbye to Ben Jones. He could go down to the tour division and, ride with them. That is the PBR's minor league division, which there are some very good bull riders in that division. I actually saw an event a couple years back, and although it didn't, you know, wasn't PBR, I mean, it wasn't Ford Built Tough caliber, you know, because you're so used to seeing those top guys but those young guys in the touring pro division, they're very good, and they deserve to be there. And you know, you're gonna need to check them out. Those are your young guys coming into the PBR. The PBR also is going to be saying goodbye to Chris Shivers. Chris Shivers calling it a career after this season. His whole purpose of the season was to get 90 point rides. The PBR went back into its archives and said, you know something, Chris, we had you at 87, but you actually have 93. Chris Shivers now has his 90-point rides at 93. Actually, he got another one this past week in Atlanta, and Chris Shivers has decided to call it a career after a wonderful, amazing career. He finally, we'll get back into that more next week and When the Dust Settles. Also, I'm going to tease you a little bit. Coming to just announce that the Iron Cowboy event, one of the PBR's premier athletes, is coming back. I'll talk more about that athlete next week's show, but I just want to let you know that one of their premier athletes, and you can't talk about this athlete without showing his highlight reel, is coming back to at the Iron Cowboy event. But let's get into the Atlanta event. The Ford Built Tough Series also said bye to Douglas Duncan, but welcome Douglas Duncan back as an alternate. And you know something? Douglas Duncan did not disappoint people. He got in the back of Black & Decker, Orange Crush, and ended up riding a 71 3/4 ride. This is where I'm saying re-ride option. The bull was kind of flat. They gave him a re-ride option. He gets in the back of Bad Moon, scores an 88. Very good score. I want to talk about Ryan Dirt Eater. Ryan Dirt Eater, you know, was coming in as your number three, number four bull rider in the world. He gets in the back of Hot and Juicy. He gets on the back of another bull, takes his re-ride auction. He gets Rockstar, 85 and 3/4 points. This is the guy I want to talk about because this is the guy that really took a chance in the second round. Stormy Wing gets on the back of, he gets on the back of Juicy Fruit and scores an 85 points on the back of Juicy Fruit. Remember that he scored an 85 points on the back of Juicy Fruit because we're going to be talking about him later. Valderon D. Oliveira, number two bull rider in the world, scores an 84 and 3/4 points on the back of Monsoon. What did your number one bull rider in the world do? Now, let me tell you, the difference between the number one and number two bull riders wasn't really that tough. If one of these guys ride their bulls, somebody was going to advance really big. And if J.P. Mooney did not ride Unpredictable, then Valderon D. Oliveira probably would be your number one bull rider going into this week coming up in Houston. But J.P. Mooney does get on the back of Unpredictable and does ride Unpredictable for 88 points. So, I mean, that was just some highlights of your top bull riders. Marco Aguche, who's riding with a couple broken ribs, gets on the back of Hot Toddy. He rides his bull for 86.5. You know, some of the guys that you thought would ride didn't ride. You know, Cody Nancy, he didn't get a ride. Austin Meyer, another one on the back of Flashpoint, he got a ride, 86.5. Austin Meyer is starting to ride, you know, just he's riding with a purpose. Ty Boselbon, which I thought was a surprise, gets on the back of South Point. He does not ride. He gets bucked off for in 3.28 seconds. And Chris Shivers gets on the back of Frontier Fugitive, 87.75 points. So your four felt tough around now. Now, there was 18 completed rides. 35 bull riders went out with some alternates. 18 completed rides. Usually your four-bill tough round is 10. This ended up becoming 18. The schematics, and we're going to have to do it in two here. We're going to start out with number 18. The 18th rider is Fabiano Vieira, and he ends up with King Lopez, Caleb Sanderson, Luke Snyder, Savano Alves, Aaron Roy, Justin Kuhn, Valderon D. Oliveira. You know, he was in the middle of the pack there with his ride. Stormy Wing, Jordan Hupp, Cody Lostrode, Renato Nunes, Ryan Dirt Eater, Cord McCoy, Marco Aguche, Austin Meyer, Chris Shivers, Douglas Duncan, and J.P. Mooney would round out the top 18 as they qualified in round one. Obviously, like I said, all these riders had a completed ride in round one. They get into round two.